Hello everyone, welcome to the tutorial on cloud computing using Azure. So it is the Microsoft component which gives us cloud computing features. So today's session will be about the brief introduction about cloud computing. So this is our introductory session. Cloud computing is a term that is nowadays heard everywhere, but when we think that we want to learn cloud computing or we want to switch to cloud computing, then it is very important that we understand what is the current scenario in on-premises solutions and how cloud computing takes us to something different, something better. So once we understand that, then only we can decide that whether we want to move to or learn cloud computing. So in case of these traditional systems, these on-premises systems, we find difficulties whenever we want to develop or deploy some applications. Whatever we want to do, anything, any software, suppose we want to create any application we want to create and we want to deploy, then the first thing we have to do that we have to think about the physical infrastructure, means at least we need some desktops, some laptops, some network connectivity, so some memory, so all these physical hardware things that we need, that is the first thing we need. And then we need the required software, means first of all we need the operating system we have to install. Suppose in case it's a laptop, then I have to first install any operating system that is preferable for my application. Then I need some several software. I have to think of the licensing. Suppose I want to know that okay, how many people are going to work in this particular application. So maybe suppose one development tool. So I need to decide on how many licenses I required, all this. So these are all prerequisites to start or deploy any type of application. So that we have already seen in traditional systems. We are used to that, okay. So I can say that these are the all are the obstacles. Suppose I am a computer engineer, a computer programmer, and I want to develop some application. I have some great idea in mind. I want to start my own company, suppose. So before starting anything, I have to first think of the lot of infrastructure, the software, all this cost. I have to calculate everything. I have to assume a lot of things, that how many machines will be required, how much licenses of the softwares I need to buy. So all these are unnecessary obstacles I am facing. So if it would be very good if I can just, means I'm just thinking that okay, I want to develop something, and at the same time I'm getting all this required hardware and software, so that I can start my work without any hurdle and without much planning. Means maybe I can start now that okay, I will start with two computers, and as I move on, maybe I will require more and more machines, more and more software as and when I am proceeding. If all these things could be available to me, then it would be very easier for me to think only on the application part, what actually I am trying to develop, instead of doing all these all these infrastructure related complexities. So cloud computing comes into picture with all these features. So it gives us all these advantages that we are thinking of. So at this current moment, maybe if you are thinking that okay, I want to develop some application, or I want to start my own company, and I want to do some specific job, then you can do it just from now with only one machine, suppose is available to you. So you can do all these things without thinking of the entire infrastructure requirement, all the complexities, all the cost you may need. So all these details you don't need at this moment. You can start your work with minimal things, and you can proceed as and when you are proceeding, you can change your requirements. All these flexibilities are given by cloud computing. So it is you will see as we move on with a lot of details, so you will be able to understand that how cloud computing makes this application development, the entire life cycle of the application developments, very flexible and cost effective. Okay. So now we move to the next slide, which is what is cloud computing. Now I told you that this type of advantages we get with cloud computing compared to our traditional on-premise structures, but exactly what is cloud computing? So I may say that suppose you want to start a business and you don't have all your infrastructure available, so maybe you are not sure that means whether you will be able to continue or not, or what may be the entire requirement of infrastructure, everything, then we can rent something, right? Means when you go to some new city, we rent a house, and then as per our requirement, if we feel that okay, I'm going to stay in this city only, my job or my studies, something that required that I have to stay here for many years, then I can think of buying a house. But initially we do some renting, right? So it's kind of a renting resources. So when you are going to cloud, you are not buying anything permanently. It's kind of renting. You are just renting it, and as per your requirement you use it, and when you don't need it you can return, and then you don't have to continue paying money. Means if you are renting a house, you have to pay money only for the particular days or months you are staying there, right? Means once you your requirement is over, maybe you are moving to some other place, then you can stop renting and you don't have to pay continuously. So it's the same thing with cloud computing. Here kind of you are hiring the resources, like the CPU cycles, the storage space, anything, suppose any computer, you are just renting, you are using, and once it is done, your requirements are over, then you can just give back to the provider. So there are many cloud providers available in the market. The major of them are Microsoft, Amazon and Google. So here in these tutorials we are going to discuss on Microsoft Azure systems. Okay, these cloud providers are responsible for the physical hardware required to execute your work and for keeping it up to date. So whatever work I am going to do, I will just log in the Microsoft Azure system, and then I will, as per my requirement, I will rent something, I will use it, maybe if I am using for 2 months, I will pay for 2 months, and once my requirements are over, then I can just give back to the provider that I don't need it anymore, and as soon as I give back, then they will not charge us anything from that moment onwards. Okay, make running a business easier and more efficient. So as I can, whenever I require, I can just rent something, I can use it, I can give it back. So all these things make the process of entire business, the entire application life cycle process, simple and efficient. Okay, now as I told you that cloud providers give us some renting resources. So what are the resources? Actually there are many different types of resources, but they can be broadly divided into four parts. They are called compute power, storage, networking and analytics. Okay, what is compute power? It is like Linux servers or web applications. It's kind of you know, the server means the location, the entire maybe some application as well, where you can use your code, means you can just execute your code, or you can just see something, you can just load something. So that is the compute power. We'll come in detail, more detail about it. Then comes storage. Storage is simple, means in your laptop you have some file folders, those are also storage, and the database system, SQL Server, that is also kind of storage, we are storing the data. So this type of different storage options are also available with the cloud providers. Then comes networking. Networking is very important, because as there are multiple machines or multiple systems, then it is required that there should be some secure connection between them. So that is also being provided by the cloud provider only. So maybe I want to make some connection with the cloud connection and to some other place in my company, so that I can do with this cloud provider solutions. Then come analytics, such as visualizing telemetry and performance data. So it's kind of some visualization tools that are also available with the cloud providers that we can hire. Okay, so let us discuss on compute power first. So here servers are required for processing each request and returning a response. So that we have already discussed that whenever we want to process any request, suppose you are doing some buying option in the Amazon server, right? So in the Amazon application, maybe you put request for some items, then you submit it. So what happens actually, this request is sent to the server, and from the server maybe some processing are done, and then the responses are generated. Maybe some information comes to you that okay, this item will reach you on this time, and intimation is sent to the warehouses where exactly the items are kept, and all this means the entire life cycle. So we always need from this client server request and response process. So for that servers are required. Okay, so these servers are being provided by the cloud providers, and it can be in different ways. Okay, that how the compute power is defined means how it is being provided by the cloud provider. So the first option is virtual machine. Virtual machine is very simple. It's like kind of you are hiring one laptop or one desktop. So it's kind of emulation of a computer. Okay, so whenever you are hiring a virtual machine from the cloud provider, so it's like you get one machine, that's it, and it is having all the required hardware and the operating system. So you get some new machine, maybe suppose you are buying some laptop from the shop. So what you are getting all the hardware in place and the operating system installed, most of the cases. So once you buy that laptop, then whatever software you require, you just install that in your machine. It's also the same thing. Instead of buying the machine for lifetime, what you are doing, you are just renting one virtual machine from the cloud provider. It provides you with the hardware and the operating system, then whatever software you need, you can install. Okay, next comes containers. So what is a container? It's kind of that when I don't need the entire machine, maybe. Okay, so instead of hiring the entire virtual machine, what I am asking for a container. So what is it? Suppose I have developed one application, and to execute this application there are some dependencies. So everything together, the application and all the dependencies, are packaged into a container. Okay, then one standard runtime environment is used to execute the app. So the entire machine is not given to you. Instead of that, in the machine some location or some place is given to you where your entire application and all the required dependencies are loaded together, and then whenever required that application can be executed. Okay, so we don't need a specific operating system from the cloud provider. So we are not going in that detail. Instead of that, what I am telling the cloud provider, that this is the application I want to execute, and these are the all dependencies for that application. So once I give everything, then it creates a container for me, and it keeps all the application and dependencies there, and whenever required that application can be executed. So what is the advantage there? First of all, that multiple containers can be run on a single machine. So when I am asking for a virtual machine, then I am getting one as if one entire computer I'm getting, but when I'm asking for container, then maybe there can be multiple containers running at the same time on a single machine. And another advantage is that containers can be moved between machines. Means suppose you have one container created, then it can be moved from one system to another system. Suppose it's dev environment to QA environment to prod environment, like that. If there are different environments, you can just move the container from one machine to another machine. So this is one type of compute power. Okay, next comes the serverless computing. This is another type of compute power. Here run applications code without creating, configuring or maintaining a server. So nothing is being done, means no configuration is required. Here suppose I have developed one application which has some separate functionalities, and they can be run independently. Means when I have, suppose in an application there are four functions and they have some different ways of working, means they have some different purpose and they are totally independent of each other, then they can be assumed that okay, there are four tasks, so I can have some triggers for those tasks, and whenever some action is happen, that particular function will be executed. That's what my requirement is. That's it. So what I am asking the cloud provider, instead of asking for the entire virtual machine, instead of asking for the container, because container, you know that there are some dependencies on the applications together they want to run, so they need a space. But here I don't need that much complexity. I have single functions which will be executed independently. So I am just asking the cloud provider that I have this application having these four functions. They need to be executed for these reasons and they are independent. So what the cloud provider does, it does that it puts those functions independently, and it is just means it will charge you only when the functions are getting executed. So you are not booking anything. It's kind of a, you know, the some shared location, some shared room kind of thing. So here all the functions are put in one place, and whenever required any function is executed, and when some function is executed then only I have to pay, otherwise I don't have to pay. So it's not like that I am booking the entire slot. It's kind of that whenever I require then I am paying. So that is the feature of serverless computing. So this is one diagram that is that I have taken from Azure. Okay, so here you can see the different types of compute power. First one is the virtual machine. So here you can see that first of all there is physical hardware. So you can assume that this kind of a machine. So here it is physical hardware. Then I have host operating system. Then I have some hypervisor controller. So what it does, it kinds of divides this entire machine in some multiple machines. So these are virtual hardware. So it you can do also, right? In your machine you can have multiple operating systems, then as if they will behave like there are two systems, like, so it's also like the same thing. Maybe in one machine there are two virtual hardwares, and I have one part I have this operating system Windows and one I have Linux, and then these apps are installed here. So it's like virtual machine 1, virtual machine 2. So it's actually one physical machine, and they can create some multiple virtual machines. So when I'm asking for a virtual machine to the cloud provider, then they will just give me link to this part. So I'm not aware that how many virtual machines are actually existing in the entire physical hardware. So I am only bothered about my virtual machine. Then this part will act as one machine for me, where the hardware and the operating system will already be installed, and I can install whatever I want. So these are my applications. So this way this virtual machine works. Then comes container. So here I have this physical hardware, then I have host operating system, then I have one thing called container engine. So what it does, actually it maintains that in the single machine there are some multiple containers. So you can see that the container has two part. One is the app and there are the dependencies. So if I am asking for one container to the cloud provider, then they may give you this container one. So I only see this part, so I know that this is my container. It is having my application and all the required dependencies, so that whenever required I can execute my application. And this may be some other containers which are given to some other users, that's fine. So it's like one physical server is being used by many people. Then I have this serverless computing. Here I have the physical hardware, I have the host operating system, then I have this software that is serverless runtime. So what it does, it has, you can see in the top level there are many functions together. So the single machine is having many functions, maybe they are totally independent from many different users. So these functions are kept there, and whenever required these functions are getting executed, and the function owner is charged as and when the functions are executed. So this is how I can take compute power from the cloud providers in different ways. So that is now for this session. In the next session we'll continue further on this topic. Okay, thank you.